right? And you'll see how it contrasts with Wednesday. This is the threats confidence where, you know, there is almost a medium level threat of tornadoes today. There is between medium and high level threats of hail and wind and low to medium of flooding. When you look across Kentucky, almost all of us are at least in slight risk. And then we start worrying about the three, which is the enhanced risk. And we think the forecast will likely only get worse as the days go on. But think about the large portion of Kentucky that lives in that enhanced risk area, from E-Town to Louisville, Frankfort to Lexington. I'm taking this seriously. This is where my family lives. And I hope everyone else will take it seriously too. Again, very large hail. We think it could be 2 inches even. And the potential for tornadoes, will really be watching after this first round comes through, whether the sun comes out. It'll be better if it's cloudy. That's less charge that's out there. We've seen, like we did on our last round of 20-plus tornadoes, what happens when the sun comes out in between. Again, Tuesday night, that is tonight. Be concerned when you go to bed about how you will get the information if there is a warning. These warnings come really fast. The way these storms can develop, it can happen very quickly. I want to thank our meteorologists, all of our news teams that are out there, how seriously they're taking this and will take it. So make sure you're prepared. Let's go to slide 3. Okay, so this is again Tuesday, and it's really showing you parts of Kentucky where, listen, the yellow is already serious, but when you get the slashes that are here, we don't get those very often in Kentucky. So the first image shows golf ball size or larger hail possibilities. That is a large part of Kentucky that can damage vehicles, homes, and property. Agricultural damage is possible, as well as injury to those caught outside. So when these hit, you do not want to be outside. And we'll talk about that in a minute, that we'll need people inside and off the roads, because if we have really damaging thunderstorms, if we have tornadoes, emergency vehicles will need to get to places as quickly as possible. The second image shows where we could see up to 70 mile per hour wind that can cause tree damage. Obviously, those trees can go into your home. They can down power lines. They can damage cars. They can damage you if you are out there close enough to it. This is almost all of Kentucky where we could see straight line winds of 70 miles an hour or more. And then the last piece shows where significant tornadoes are possible. Typically, when you have that area that we're talking about, the yellow with the slashes, that's EF2 or higher. Those are very damaging tornadoes. But remember, even the brown area is very possible to get these tornadoes. And we saw them not long ago when we would see, you know, short duration tornadoes, but we had over 22 during one day in Kentucky in early April. Remember that while we saw a lot of damage, we didn't have many injuries during that because people were weather aware. We need you to be just as weather aware this afternoon into Thursday morning, because this early forecast is worse than the forecast we received before that event. All right, now let's go into Wednesday. Listen, we're concerned about today. We're very concerned about Wednesday. Wednesday, we expect to see scattered severe storms. Again, Wednesday afternoon right now, we think 4 p.m.-ish, but that will change depending on how quickly this moves across the country. And so we will be providing more updates, but check with your local meteorologist. Make sure you are watching the news. This is very capable of tornadoes, very large hail, and damaging winds. Again, look down here, Wednesday, the tornado confidence is between medium and high. That should be concerning to everyone. The hail confidence between medium and high. The wind confidence between medium and high. And then again, there's the flooding. But as we are moving, especially into late Wednesday night, early Thursday morning, we may have had so much rain that these flood confidence change. It all depends on how much a given area gets. So make sure you're watching, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, and going into Thursday morning when we could see more of that. There is a belief that we may move from a 3 to even a 4. You know, the 3 is the enhanced risk. The 4 is the moderate risk, which is the second highest. It only goes to 5. And we're at a 2 or a 3 across most of the state. This 3 goes all the way into western Kentucky, which you can't fully see. The 2 goes all the way through eastern Kentucky. Strong tornadoes, EF2s or greater, cannot be ruled out. Additional storms, possibly in the form of a squall line, are expected Wednesday night, with all severe hazards still possible. Remember, in that weather system in early April, we didn't lose an individual during the tornadoes. We lost them during that initial squall when they were out on the roads, and just that intense rain caused a car accident where we lost a young man. So be careful during this. Let's go to the next slide. Again, this shows you exactly how significant of an event we are looking at. There's enhanced risk of severe thunderstorms. That is a 3 out of 5 for eastern Kentucky on Wednesday and Wednesday night. The tornado risk is greatest generally near the west of Interstate 75. But look again at the hail probability. That covers most of the Commonwealth. That again is in the red with the severity over top. The wind probability now covering most all of the state. Look at the confidence in that 70-mile-an-hour winds. You don't have to have a tornado to topple some trees, to lose some parts of roofs, to have power lines come down. And then look at the tornado possibility, especially for western Kentucky. You've been through this a lot. Make sure that you are prepared and ready, because, again, this is significant, and we believe that it could get more significant as we go. We'll see a lot today about where this weather system is. Let's go to the next one. Okay, we could see a lot of rain. This is probably the most uncertain piece, but the confidence is still medium that we will have flooding chances. We think it could create flash floods in some of the initial storms, but our biggest concern is the amount of rain that we could get over a 2-day or a 2-day and change period of time. Some areas could have multiple rounds of heavy downpours and storms. We're talking about 1 to 3 inches of rainfall with higher amounts possible. So remember, if you are out on the roadways and you hit flooding, turn around and don't drown. We've lost far too many people thinking that they could get through something. It's not worth it. You love your family a lot more than where you're trying to get to. Turn around. Don't drive through flooded areas. Nighttime flooding is especially dangerous. Also much harder to get to you if you are swept away or in a dangerous position. Let's hit the next one. So we are asking everyone to take action now and to be specifically ready for nighttime severe weather, including nighttime tornadoes. We've lived through this. We wish we hadn't. And remember, in 2021, we lost 81 people in the worst tornado event that the state's ever seen. Decimated Mayfield. It took a lot of lives in Bremen. It pretty much destroyed my dad's hometown of Dawson Springs, and they are all rebuilding. But it tells you how concerning that nighttime tornadoes can be. Nighttime flooding hit eastern Kentucky in really tough ways. Hit Nicholas County several years before. So you need a weather radio or other means of getting those alerts, if that means pulling the phone into your bedroom if you don't normally put it there. So Kentuckians can listen to weather warnings by having an NOAA weather radio, listening to local TV and radio updates, connecting to wireless emergency alerts and weather apps, listening for outdoor sirens, visiting weather.gov or mobile.weather.gov, or receiving notifications from family, friends, and coworkers. Be prepared tonight and tomorrow night. Protect your family, protect yourself. If you don't have a weather radio, go get one today before 4 p.m. Make sure you have batteries for it. Again, let's go to the next slide. Turn around. Don't drown. I keep thinking about making it through all the most difficult parts of these weather emergencies and then losing people to carbon monoxide by having a generator too close to your house, or people trying to drive through a flooded area and losing them then. These are all avoidable, right? It's not a tornado tearing through your house. It is avoidable. It's about making good decisions and just having the right risk and tolerance. Your family, your friends, they love you. They want you to be here tomorrow. It's more important than where you think you need to get to going through a flooded area. A few other updates. We're taking this seriously enough to where we are going to close state office buildings beginning at 2 p.m. today to help make sure our state employees are able to make it home safely. And what we're asking them is to be inside by 4 p.m. to have those roads clear. It's probably safer if you're inside a little bit earlier. It might not hit you until a little bit later, but I know if we can get some part of our 20 plus thousand employees home safe and off the road, that our Commonwealth is safer. Given tomorrow and given the weather pattern expected and trying to give people time to prepare, we're going to close our state office buildings on Wednesday at 2 p.m. as well. Thus, the state government provides a lot of important services, and we don't take this lightly. But I've governed through tornadoes and floods and polar plunges and ice storms and just about anything else we've seen, and I care about every single one of our employees. I care about every single Kentuckian out there, and I would rather be safe and careful than to lose even one life. So again, we're closing our state office buildings today at 2 p.m., and tomorrow, Wednesday at 2 p.m. And we're going to be watching the forecast on Thursday morning. I expect that we'll be able to come in as normal. But if you are a state employee, watch for updates. If we've got to push it back just a little bit, we might do that just to make sure you're safe. Now, we've got a lot of folks that will have to be in because they're the folks that respond to events like this. They're emergency management, which does a great job. There are transportation cabinet that does a great job. There are cut teams in forestry and others that are out there. Our Kentucky Emergency Operations Center has been activated, and essential partners are standing by to provide support as needed. So again, we urge Kentuckians in need of a safe place to contact their local emergency management office or official. If you don't know where you'd go if there was a tornado, if where you typically stay isn't safe, find out now. Find out this morning. Make sure you know where to go. For additional preparedness tips, visit kyem.ky.gov. Now you're going to hear from Kentucky Division of Emergency Management Eric Gibson, followed directly by State Highway Engineer James Ballinger.
Well, good morning, and thank you, Governor Beshear, for the valuable information that you prepared today. We do have a significant weather event, according to all our partners at the National Weather Service, and it is important that we prepare. Kentucky Emergency Management is going to be operating at a heightened awareness during this period. We will have staff on scene at the office building during this event. By activating now, we will increase our situational awareness for the event. It'll ensure faster response times in case there is a need, and we'll have good lines of clear communication to our citizens. We'll also have proactive recovery measures in place in case there is a loss. We'll continue to work with the National Weather Service as we watch this storm coming across our Commonwealth, and we will continue to keep this Emergency Operations Center open until the storm passes through the Commonwealth. Just remember during this time to be weather aware, secure your property, stay updated. The weather radio that was mentioned by the governor is very valuable to updates throughout the night while you're sleeping. Check on your loved ones and follow the local guidance. It will be updated as the storm is passing through. During this time, if you were to experience a damage to your home or property, please document that and report that before beginning any of the cleanup efforts. By doing that documentation will be vital for the recovery assistance programs that are available and for improving future preparedness. The safety of each Kentuckian is our top priority. We're here to support the citizens of the Commonwealth and provide the most updated information that we have. Please take all warnings seriously and prepare accordingly. We will continue to provide updates throughout the day as the situation updates. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Governor. And given the potential for the severe weather that's expected over the next couple of days, though, our state highway crews are on high alert. We're monitoring the weather. And in fact, we just held a statewide meeting just before I came to this press event to discuss our plans and our preparation for the upcoming weather event over the next couple of days. And our crews, if we experience a wind event, our crews will respond should downed trees or other debris impact travel on our state maintained routes due to the high winds. If you're on the road during a high wind event, slow down, keep your hands on the wheel, and keep a safe distance from other cars, especially the large semi trucks that you may see on the roadway. Or even better, just safely pull over if you're out in the weather and you have a high wind event that you're experiencing. Another thing, if we experience the water or the flooding that the governor talked about, crews are going to be monitoring for this high water on our roadways. And we'll place barricades and signs, though, as needed. But the most important thing, though, is to turn around and don't drown. It only takes just a few inches of water on a roadway that could float a vehicle. So that's the main thing. I'm going to reiterate that. Turn around, don't drown. Also, depending on the severity of the storms, our roadways could be blocked by downed power lines. The main thing is to report a downed power line to your utility company and do not try to clear that yourself, though. It's just really important, though, to avoid touching any downed power lines that you may experience. Also, remember that power outages could affect our traffic signals. Should you encounter a dark traffic signal, the most important thing to do is treat that intersection as a four-way stop. That way you can maintain your safety and the safety of other drivers and motorists on the highway. Again, our highway crews and the utility companies will respond to storm damage just as quickly as we possibly can, but we also have to look at the safety of our crews. It takes time, so we ask for your patience as we respond to these weather events over the next couple of days. Mainly though, avoid travel when it's not safe. And please watch out for our crews and the other first responders that you may experience, though, after the storm event has passed. Thank you.
So in summary, over the next couple of days, late afternoon into the evening, we fully expect intense rain, hail, and high winds. And there is certainly the possibility of significant tornadoes. So think about what you need to do. Get in the car in the garage if you have it. Making sure you get any lawn furniture, because it's been nice inside. Making sure you get your pets out before the intense weather is coming. Making sure you have that weather radio, knowing where your kids are and making sure they are in a safe place. You know, go through that list in your head. This is why we've been safe through a lot of very difficult weather events. It's being weather aware and having seen the worst of the worst, making sure that we are careful. With that, I think we have just one journalist on the line, and that's Tom Latek.
Thank you very much, Governor, and good morning to you. I've got a couple questions. Do we have any Kentucky National Guard folks been put on standby or activated? And secondly, have you heard anything from Washington yet on your request for a disaster declaration from last month's severe weather?
So we have not heard about last month's severe weather declaration. We were at least initially denied for the Carroll Trimble Gallatin County event that came before it. We will appeal that, but haven't heard back as of yet on this most recent one. At this point, we haven't activated National Guard. Now, we have the active on-duty National Guard that is always on duty over at the Emergency Operations Center, and we're going to be watching. The forecast is still a little bit in flux. We want to see what happens, especially after this first line comes through. And then we'll be watching some of the early indications that we see what happens on our roadways. Our hope is that we'll get people home and off the roadways really before that 4 p.m. time when we think that this will hit and hit significantly. All right, everybody, stay safe. We care about each and every one of you. We've seen what happens here. We've seen pictures out of Oklahoma and other areas of severe weather recently. Be weather aware. so that Thursday afternoon and Friday, when it stops raining and hopefully the sun comes out, you'll be there making great memories with your family. Thank you all very much.